It only took a few moments of the trailer to get me interested in the puzzle game Tamashii, and now that I just got done playing it, is Tamashii dark and dandy, or is it a satanic snooze fest? Tamashii is a very creepy puzzle platform game where you're playing as an unnamed character who is summoned and then sent into a temple to find out what's corrupting it. As this character, you venture into the temple, which works as the hub for the game. There's a bunch of rooms here, some of which are the game's levels. These levels are broken up into multiple rooms that you'll have to solve puzzles in and make your way through, eventually concluding with a boss encounter. There are different paths in these ones that are less and more challenging, with bigger rewards for the more challenging paths. The main aspect of solving the game's puzzles and even fighting the bosses is making clones of yourself. You have to place them strategically around the room, and there's a lot of creativeness when it comes to solving the game's puzzles that you'll have to do in order to move on through some of the game's later levels. There's new traps, hazards, as well as new types of blocks that get in your way all throughout the course of the levels, so you'll have to constantly keep changing up your strategies a bit in order to figure out how to get these clones in those right spots in order to go through the next door. For the bosses, instead of taking them head on, you'll have to set your clones up on turrets to fire at them, or in some cases, just escape the room while solving a puzzle along the way. Each new boss encounter presented new challenges and was pretty creatively done, so I looked forward to getting to each new one of these encounters. The puzzles, as well as even the platforming itself, is more on the challenging side of things. If you're someone who gets easily frustrated with puzzles, you may not really necessarily like the game as much, but if you're looking for a decent challenge in that department, I think Tamashii presents it. Its only real downside, though, is the game isn't exceptionally long, only roughly about an hour and a half to 2 hours to see it through, but it's a heck of a ride while it lasts. Once you complete a level, you can redo them. There's score attack, time trial mode, as well as there's Easter eggs, secrets, and the like to keep an eye out for throughout the game. Also included are some options to tweak some of the graphics, as well as make the game a bit more accessible. Presentation-wise, I really liked the graphics, the mix of horror, H.R. Giger's art, some satanic imagery, and Lovecraft stuff all blended together for a sort of surreal experience that I honestly just couldn't get enough of. From the technical side of things, there was no crashing or other major glitching. Tamashii is available on the PlayStation 4 for $11.99. It does feature a platinum trophy. The game is also available on Nintendo Switch, Xbox One, and PC. Overall, Tamashii is one of those games that not only brings an interesting visual aspect, but its gameplay is very creative and enjoyable as well. I liked the puzzles in each one of the rooms, as well as the boss fights were extremely satisfying to complete. If you are a puzzle platform fan, I think this is one you're going to enjoy, as long as you like the graphics as well, as I know they won't be everybody's cup of tea. With everything said, I'm going to be giving Tamashii on the PlayStation 4 an 8. Out of 10. That's gonna wrap up this review though. I'd like to thank you for watching, and of course, I hope you enjoyed.